What's up, guys? Today we're gonna be reviewing some toffee. First things first, I wanna show you this cool shirt I got today. It says, love yourself while it looks in the mirror. Also, this cool Pilsner glass in it with some water and has like a bunny there and... water tastes great. Let's review the toffee. We're gonna be using a guitar pick. Toffee Fae. I'm gonna use a guitar pick to open it up, and let's see what it tastes like. We got that, and then... oh, my bad. Goes like this. What kind of technology is that? Got the box, don't need that no more. Now we got the toffee face, so... we're gonna open this up and see what it tastes like. First things first, let's open it up. Usually, it just opens up so easily with this line, but I'm having a hard time finding it right now. There, this is what they look like. This is how you get them out. So you grab your finger and then you just pop it out. Let's see what it tastes like. So for our first tasting, we're gonna be biting it in half, seeing what the textures are, and then we'll be doing the review. A note to point out, in case I bite the whole nut out, is there is a nut in between here. It's a hazelnut, just like the package says. Hazelnut, so I'll try to bite half and see if the hazelnut's there. If it's not there, just assume that I've eaten it already. This is what the middle looks like. So you see you got your three chocolate layers. You got, let's see if I can focus. You got first the caramel, milk chocolate, I think, then a dark chocolate, then the hazelnut. Something that, one sec, more review. Let's start with the positives. Something I find very appealing about this toffee is the chewiness to it, how much the caramel adds and enhances the flavor of the chocolate. Because it's at that outer shell, you really have to chew it until you get to the chocolate, and it's like you're battling to get that flavor of the chocolate, but it's a give and a take, and it's so delightful to eat. Another positive that the variety in the toffee adds is the nut and the crunch it adds to it, because not only are you getting something chewy at first, but then you get a nice crunch and it just brings all the flavors together. The white chocolate sustains the sweetness as the dark chocolate near the end hammers the dark chocolate flavor in. So overall, you just get a smooth flavor composition all the way around. You're never just getting stagnant with something. Something is either increasing or decreasing, hence the caramel chewiness to the sustaining of the white chocolate to the spike of the dark chocolate. Is the flavor composition makes sense all the way around. Something that is a little triggering about this is the package. It's a little like you can't put this back. Like you can put it back inside the box, but you can't, like, that's unstable. And then if you like Oh, it's in my backpack. Oh, going to school, whatever. Going to school, whatever. And then it's like, oh, and oh crap, my toffee fell out. That was a scam. See, and that would suck, but the packaging, and the packaging also comes in very large quantities. You can't just have a few toffee fae, but I think that's more to the company than to the actual flavor of it. So I'm gonna, based on my review, I'm gonna be reviewing it based off of the food and not the packaging. So on a candy rating scale, I'm gonna give the toffee fae, probably an 87.9285, because, I take that back, probably a 88.892, because I think that it is good, and the flavors do sustain themselves, but I don't think that the chocolate is necessarily high-quality chocolate, where maybe it is, but with all the diversity in flavor, I don't really know what kind of quality of chocolate am I getting. Am I getting nice European? Am I getting bad, like, wait, what's the word? I'm getting bad, like, wax chocolate. Like, I don't know really what I'm getting. So, like, that's why I can't give it a full 100%. But overall, delicious candy. That's the video. Bye.